Hello, I'm Abhinav Deshpande and I'm a sixth grader attending Stoddard Middle School. I will be reciting a poem I wrote entitled Hope, A Light in the Dark. Hope. I like to think of it as the light that shines vibrantly in a sea shrouded in darkness, the light that at first seems desolate, but then spreads like a wildfire, igniting all objects in its path. With the uncontrollable flame that sparks faith into that shroud of darkness. Hope. It's defined as a feeling of expectation or desire for a certain thing to happen. However, sometimes you're in desperation to find that expectation and you require the ability to acquire the desire. And thus, the light flickers dismally before going out, leaving the sea shrouded in darkness and in doubt. But when this happens, you must break the chains that imprison you to the cell of gloom, free yourself from the shackles that bind you to the rock that states you are doomed. You must find the power to find the light within, ignite the flame that permits hope to break in. For hope, it's always present, even when it can't be clearly seen. It's always present during times that aren't serene. For example, you know the sun still exists, even when daytime is past. You know the moon is real even when it's noon. You know that you can experience sunny weather even if you are witnessing blizzards and monsoons. You know that cells exist even if they're invisible to the naked eye. You know that birds are real even if you don't see any animals flying in the sky. Well, if all of this is true, why do we fail to notice hope when times are blue? Aesop once said, "After the rain cometh the fair weather." While this fair weather, there has to be a cause for this. Similarly, for there to be happiness after a time of misery, there has to be a root cause for that happiness, and that is hope. H.W. Longfellow once wrote, "Behind the clouds, the sun is still shining." This shows that even when times may seem as dark as night, there will always be hope to bring in the light.
da 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 da. They won't see through my disguise, right here behind my eyes, replaying in my mind, la da da. Look at me, I'm as helpless as a kitten up a tree, and it feels like I'm clinging to a cloud. I can't understand, I get misty just holding your hand. Walk my way as a thousand violins begin to play, or maybe the sound of your hello, the music I hear, I get misty the moment you're near.
She gon' fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up. She don't need makeup, makeup, makeup. She gon' rake it up, rake it up, rake it up. Tell her to pay up, pay up. She said, pay for the, pay for the, pay. Wait for the, wait for the, wait. Ask God to forgive me. Cause I pray for the, I tell all my, rake it up, break it down, bag it up. Bag it up, bag it up, bag it up, bag it up, rake it up, rake it up, rake it up, rake it up, bag it up, bag it up, bag it up, bag it up. I tell all my what, rake it up, break it, break it down, break it down, bag it up, 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 bag it up. Get up, get up, get up, break it up, break it up.
Like who, bet? Ballin' in the big diamond hoops, yeah. I done make a big ball of moves, yeah. Got them boys jumping through hoops. Damn, ho, 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 hoops, yeah. Rose rings hanging from my ears, yeah. Everybody shining up in here, yeah. Got them boys jumping through hoops. Damn, ho, 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 hoops.
Today, I'm gonna interpret an excerpt of the play Typical Teen by Joseph Arnold. This excerpt revolves around an argument between a mother and a teenage daughter, where the daughter, Shazira, wants to follow on her interest of figure skating, but her mom won't make it easy on her. You go on and on like you were the only one that has a life. I have court cases that demand all of my time because people's lives depend on the choices I make. It is all on me. The least you can do is the one or two things I ask and expect of you. Ugh! I wish you were there for me more and would get off my back with all these little useless things. I am sick of it. All you do is go on and on and on about your court cases, your useless work. That's all you talk about. You are always in a mood, always angry or sad, and it drives me crazy because I don't understand why you are always like that. You never smile. You are never happy whenever I try to talk to you about anything. I am always met with the negative energy. We can never be close. What demands do I ever put on you? You know, it is always bickering. As soon as you see me, you bicker at me. You have no idea what I go through. I want you to get off my back and let me live my life.
Look, Shazira, it has been a long day for me yet, and this isn't over yet.
I hear what you are saying, okay? Let's agree to work at it. Deal?
Deal. Finally, what did we all interpret from this whole argument? Were the issues being discussed really that big?
No, they really weren't. What was missing in the whole relationship? Well, it was a lack of understanding between the teenager and the mother. This excerpt
beautifully illustrates the important theme of empathy. Resuming life after the pandemic has been difficult. Our daily schedules are packed up like never before. This is causing frustration among many of us. We must be empathetic to one another and communicate our thoughts and feelings with the ones closest to us. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Fateh Khatra, and today I'm going to be demonstrating board breaking, a form of the martial art Taekwondo. As of now, I am a third degree black belt. I will now proceed to breaking the two wooden boards with a jump front kick and a hammer fist.
Quit calling you my lover. Move on. You watch me bleed until I can't breathe. Shaking, falling onto my knees. And now that I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing stitches. Tripping over myself. Aching, begging you to come help.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno. But it was my wedding day.
Wedding day.
We were getting ready and there wasn't a cloud in the sky.
No clouds allowed in the sky.
Bruno walks in with a mischievous grin.
Thunder!
You telling a story or am I?
I'm sorry for to go on.
Bruno says it looks like rain.
What did you tell us?
In doing so, he floods my brain.
Oh, will I get the umbrella?
Married in a hurricane.
What a joyous day, but anyways,
we don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
Hey, could live in a fib and a stuttering and stumbling. I can always hear him sort of muttering and mumbling. I associate him with the sound of falling sand. It's a heavy lift with a gift still humbling. Oh, to the wonder and the family fumbling. Grappling with prophecies I couldn't understand. Do you understand?
Seventh foot frame, rats along his back. When he calls your name, it all fades to black. Yeah, he sees your dreams
and we sound just
great. We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
No, your fate is sealed when your prophecy is read.
He told me that the life of my dreams would be promised and someday be mine. He told me that my powers would grow like the grapes that thrive on the vine. He told me that the man of my dreams would be just out of reach, but thrown to another. It's like I hear him.
Hey sis, I want not a sound out of you.
I need him now.
Bruno. Yeah, about that Bruno. I really need to know about Bruno. Give him the truth and the full truth, Bruno.
Isabella, your boyfriend's here. Time for dinner.
Everyone, my name is Alice Chin, or Junie Chin, and I'm an 8th grader from Folsom Middle School. Today, I'll be performing a song with this traditional Chinese instrument called the pipa, and the song I'll be performing is called Send Me a Rose. Hope you enjoy.
I'm in 7th grade and I'm going to be singing Tear Myself Apart by Tate McRae. So it goes, my summer rose is cut and thrown away. Petals fall and you don't call for days and days and days. You say it's not my fault. You say nothing at all. Can you see my head shake? Heart is now an earthquake. Left alone to tear myself apart. You make it look so easy. Turn around and leave me. Left alone to tear myself apart. To tear myself apart. No concern for what you've burned. You set yourself ablaze. What survives are sharpened knives that go right through the bone. You say it's not my fault. You say nothing at all. Can you see my head shake? Heart is now an earthquake. Left alone to tear myself apart. You make it look so easy. Turn around and leave me. Left alone to tear myself apart. To tear myself apart. Self apart. Can you see my head shake? Heart is now an earthquake. Left alone to tear myself apart. You make it look so easy. Turn around and leave me. Left alone to tear myself apart. To tear myself apart. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mars Duncan. I will be singing We Don't Talk About Bruno from Encanto. I'm not Spanish, so I might butcher some things. Just gonna give you a heads up. Okay.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno. But it was my wedding day. We were getting ready and there wasn't a cloud in the sky. No clouds allowed in the sky. Bruno walks in with a mischievous grin. Thunder, you're telling the story, or am I? I'm sorry, maybe it'll go on. Bruno says it looks like rain. What did he tell us? In doing so, he floods my brain. A boy like the umbrella, married in a hurricane. What a joyous day, but anyway. We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
Hey! Feel the fear when I'm standing and stumbling. I can only see the sort of muttering and mumbling. I was just sitting with the sound of falling sands. It's a heavy lift with the gift so humbling. Always the blue on the family fumbling. Grappling with prophecies they couldn't understand. Do you understand? 7 foot frame. Rats along his back. When he calls your name, it all fades to black. Yeah, he sees your dreams and feasts on your screams. We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
Great.
Alright, so I'm going to be doing some card magic. I do have a time limit, so I need to go, like, really kind of fast. How I'm going to start is I would just tell the spectator to just tell me when to stop. So let's say, like, right here. Then I would ask them which color they think this card is. And so they could just do, like, any guess. Let's just say, like, red. They actually got it right. So I'm going to put it at the top of the deck. I'll flip it over. And actually, I'll keep it right here for the next part of the trick. I'll make a cut. I like to do that. So I'll just tell them to stop. Like, say right here, the spectator tells me when. So then I would ask them what they think the color of this card is. And so they would say, let's just go with, like, black. They actually got it right. So now, right here I have the Seven of Spades. Right here we have the Queen of Diamonds. So would you be amazed if I could switch them? And they would say, like, maybe yes. So I would do this, and now I have the Queen of Diamonds. And right here, this card is the Seven of Spades. So actually, for the next trick, I need to find the two aces. And so now, basically, right here we have the Ace of Clubs. So they would hold it like this, and then without looking, I would ask them which color what the card is, and so they would say Ace of Clubs. So now we have the Ace of Spades here. So how the trick works is they would hold it like this. And I would put the card here, and I would take this card. So now, without looking, now I have the Ace of Clubs. I'm going to do that again, but super fast. Ready? All right, so now, then I would just ask the spectator if they thought that I actually switched them, or if they thought that I'm lying and I didn't actually switch them. And so they would say that they think that I switched them, maybe. And so, but actually, I have the Queens right here. And so now, basically, for this last trick, I would just tell them to, like, just pick any card. So let's just go with, like, right here. Right here we have the Five of Diamonds. It doesn't matter if I see it. But so I would put it in the deck, like, right here. I would make a cut. And so what a normal magician would do is they would try to find their card. But what I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to keep flipping over cards like this. And so not only do I not know where the card is, but I don't know the orientation of the deck like that. So now, as you can see, some cards are face down to face up. Some cards are face up to face down. And some cards are just, let's see, where is it? Some cards are face down to face down like this, right? So I'm just going to recap. I flipped over tons of cards, right? So I would ask if they could snap for me. They would snap, and now actually all the cards are face down except for their card.
Thank you.
Kalaji, and I'm an 8th grader at Folsom Middle School, and I'm going to be playing two songs on the piano today.
Thank you.
some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old. It was a big, big world, but we thought we were bigger. Pushing each other to the limits, we were learning quicker. By 11, smoking heroin, drinking burning liquor. Never, so we were out to make a steady figure. Once I was 11 years old, my daddy told me, go get yourself a wife or you'll be lonely. Once I was 11 years old. Songs, I started writing stories. Something about the glory just always seemed to bore me. Cause only those I really love will ever really know me. Once I was 11 years old, my daddy told me, go get yourself a wife or you'll be lonely. Once I was 11 years old. Once I was 20 years old, my story got told.
Today I'll be singing an original song that I wrote called Outer Space. I've been drifting in space for an hour now, but the asteroids can mislead me somehow. I don't want to be cosmic dust alive no more. I want to see what the universe has in store. Cause you said I'd be the next Pluto. You said to take notes to be better, and I did so for your red letter. I know my heart doesn't reach the stars. I know my mind left the planet Mars. I know my soul wants to see. So bright, solar flares holding what's right and wrong. I just wanna stand tall tonight, and I want the galaxies to play along. I wanna be something since the Big Bang Theory. I wanna create a shining memory. Cause the rays of the light will only find you if you seek for it. outer space no more.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Niyat Anoop from Mitchell Middle School, 6th grade. Today I'm going to attempt to solve the Rubik's Cube 3x3 in under a minute. I've never seen the shuffle before. As you can see, I solved the entire cube in before the time went. And the time is 38 seconds and 44 milliseconds. Bye.
For all of our wonderful talent show participants who submitted their amazing talents that really showcased what FCUSD is all about. So with that, I'll turn it over to Board President Mr. Reed to give us our talent show winners.
All right, thank you, Alice. This is always my favorite time of the year. I think this is my third or fourth year that I've been asked to participate as a judge in the talent show. It's really remarkable, all the wonderful talent that we have in our district. And quite frankly, it's always very hard at the same time to judge because you have so many wonderful, talented people, which are truly noteworthy. So, what we have is a couple of honorable mentions, and then I'll announce the top three. So for honorable mentions, I'd like to congratulate Bria Miller for her inspiring dancing. We have Anderson Eliason for his magic tricks. I actually watched the magic tricks a couple of times trying to figure out how he was doing that, but that was wonderful. And then Hannah Castro for her tap dancing. For the top three, I'll start at number three and work my way down to number one. At number three, we have Victor Park for his Lego stop motion. At number two, we have Catherine Nguyen for the original piano composition. And then finally at number one, we have Alice Chen for her playing of the pipa, which I've never seen that instrument before. So that was wonderful. So congratulations to all. And thank you again for letting me be a judge.
Thank